trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown.
Was it a good movie? Very good movie, very good movie. Like I said, it talks about God, doesn't it? It tells you about Christ and what he did for you, right? That's right. You know, there's opposites in the world. There's opposites in the world. There's up, there's down, there's left, there's right. There's boy, there's girl. There's man, there's woman. There's hot, there's cold. Right? That's right. There's a heaven. And if there's a heaven, there's got to be a... That's right. That's right. And there's a lot of people that are going to go there. But you know what? We're here today to show you about God. So one day, you can make a decision about where you're going to go when you die. You understand? The Bible says...
Love us.
All right, come here. Are you the boy I talked to yesterday?
Yes.
All right, come here.
There's
the boy I talked to yesterday. We're talking to people about film showing, right? And what you learned yesterday.
There's a...
Speak up.
Good story because Jesus Christ died in the cross because to forgive our sin.
That's right. Did something happen to you yesterday, you
I'm
said?
The touching of the movie.
You got touched by the movie. In your heart?
Heart.
All right. Hold up.
The people says, let's learn about Jesus.
That we mortals made our sins and Jesus forgave us because he loves us.
That's right. Amen. Very good. Very good. Here you go. Okay, how important belief is? Okay, it's John chapter 3. Verse number 18. I'm going to read it in English and then I want you to read it in Sabano, okay? I'll read it in English. He that believeth on him is not condemned. But he that believeth not is condemned already, because he hath not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. Okay, now you read it in Sabana. Okay, can you tell me, come on down here, little buddy, and you too.
I learned that. Believing is a power, and every rise of the sun, there's a new chapter, and God wants us to change and to believe in His name.
Very good, very good.
Also, Jesus forgive our sins.
You see Jesus what?
Forgive our sins.
Forgive our sins, that's right. You see Him crucified?
Yes.
Yeah, you see the nails in His hand?
And nails in His feet.
Nails in His feet, that's right. That's right. What did He do that for?
For us.
For us, that's right. For my sin and your sin, right?
Our sins.
Our sin, that's right. Congratulations. All right. Okay. Anybody else? Teachers, would you like to come? What do we want to do with the students afterwards? Remember we talked about that? About how we're going to follow up? Okay, come on. Let's say it.
Okay, yesterday, after viewing the film, so very awesome, my children in grade 4 class were very inspired. Till now, they are so very inspired with the program yesterday. So that is great. Thanks for this program, you know. And I do follow up this morning regarding the topic yesterday, regarding the film viewing yesterday. I did follow up just right this morning, and they so the pupils are very interested with that, and they really feel and they realize the love of God for them. So thanks for this. May the words of God be preached to whom the gospel of God may be preached to the whole world.
That film viewing was very, very, I think that was very effective on the part of the students, especially the grade 6 pupils particularly, because we have difficulty in dealing with them nowadays, no?
Learn
yesterday. So we would like to thank this you, sir, and your ministry for giving us this opportunity, no, the to view our pupils here, because that was very, very important. Again, that was really helpful to all of us. Thank you so much.
For that very, very nice movie that every children learn and know about Jesus, and I know they really like that movie. Thank you very much.
All right, this is the vice principal, and she was gracious enough to let us come here. We showed three movies yesterday, actually. We showed The Light of the World, that's a comic movie about the whole Bible. And also we showed the Jesus movie for kids in the afternoon. And then the third movie we showed is called a movie called The Cross. Anyway, it was a very, very good time. And we believe that the students were blessed and so much very happy. And now the teachers are going to kind of follow up on that. So anyway, thank you very much for the opportunity to come to this school. All right.
Thank you.
Stand up for Jesus. Stand up for Jesus. He's so jealous.
If you have something in bad doing things, you will be thrown to hell. If you are a good person, you will be thrown to heaven.
Continue that if he's a good person, you would go to heaven. Now, is that true or not? What do you think? Okay. So let's take the good person test. Has anybody ever took the good person test to be able to prove whether or not you're a good person or not? So let's take the good person test. Okay. The good person test is God's got his standards in which he will judge us. You understand?
Yeah.
He's got his standards. His standards are the Ten Commandments. Do you think that you've kept those commandments? Who's kept them? Thank you, Captain. Well, let's go through a few of them and let's find out if you have, okay? Have you ever told a lie? Yes, you've told a lie. So you've broken the commandments, then, hey. If you tell one lie in your whole life, it makes you what? It makes you a liar, doesn't it? All right, have you ever stolen anything before? Take a pencil, a mango, a watermelon, you know, something that didn't belong to you, right? That's stealing. So what does that make you if you steal? Makes you a thief, don't it? How many times do you have to steal to make you a thief? One time. See, it doesn't matter about the price of the object you stole. It could be 1 peso, it could be 5,000 pesos. The point is that you stole, right? Have you always loved your mother and father and done everything that they said to do? No, you know you haven't. I haven't. Have you always done what your teacher said to do? No, you know you haven't. So that is the fifth commandment. It says honor your mother and father. So you haven't done it. So by your own admission here today, by your own admission, God sees you in heaven as a liar, as a thief, and dishonoring your parents. So in actual reality, you're not really a good person, are you? You're not really a good person. You know what you are? You're a sinner. Well, that's another command, you see. Now, Jesus said, if you hate a man, you committed murder in your heart. So if you ever hated a person that did you wrong, that means you're a murderer in your heart. You see, that's sin. So that means God sees you as a murderer. Even though you didn't actually commit the crime, you wanted to. And that's sin too. You see? So that's what God sees you as. And that's why the movie yesterday was so important. on a to see where you come from creation, right? All the way on through, and what God did for you. And you see it yesterday, didn't you? So you've been warned. You've been warned. About. Now, the Bible says that everybody's appointed to die. And after that, the judgment. God will give you a judgment someday for your life. See, God does not judge you now while you're on earth. He judges you later after you die. That's what God does. See, now the civil law is different. If I go out here and I steal something, I get caught. What they do, I go in front of the judge, they say guilty, and I go to jail. It's done now, but God is different. Your judgment will come after you die. So it's important, the choices that you make now in this life while you're living. Because once you're dead, you can't come back. And somebody's dead and they go to hell, they can't come back and warn you. That's what I'm here for. Here's my life right here. See that? That's my life. These are all my sins. Christ took my life and he took it, and this is Christ. He took his life and put my life inside him. And he took that and he nailed it to the cross. So then, guess what? I give Christ's life and he takes mine. It's a switch. I did the crime, Jesus paid the fine. And he gives you a new heart that wants to do truth and wants to love, joy, peace, happiness. He gives you a new heart. So that's what God does. And he does that through simple belief. Simple belief. But to be saved, to be born again, is a belief only. It says, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Now, a long time ago, I used to be a big, big man in America. I used to be a big, rich man in America. I used to do bad things. I had my own restaurant bar where I sold liquor and whiskey. Also, in my bar, I was a drug pusher, a big drug pusher. Lots of money, see, lots of money. I thought that was what it was all about, to have money and cars. But you know what? Inside my heart, and God was mad at me because I was sinning bad. Bad man, very bad man. And he ripped it out, and he gave me a new heart. And my new heart likes truth, likes happiness, likes joy, likes good things, likes the word, the truth. You see this book? This book is the truth. And it's good to know it. I gave you a book. It's truth. And if you can believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, you can be saved. And it's your choice. Like I said, you're going to die someday. Okay? Ziggy? Okay. All right. Well, that's it. All right. Thank you.
Gracias, gracias. Thank you. Maraming salamat. Iba shalom.
All right.
Mabuhay po kayo. We learn so much from you. We share them when we go. Viva Shalom. Mabuhay po kayo.
submission, all is at rest. I and my Savior am happy and blessed, watching and waiting, looking up.